ChatGPT is an incredibly powerful AI tool, but how can you use it to be more productive and save time, both in your work life and in your personal life? Well, in this video, I've got 7 different ways in which we can get the most out of this tool. Now, first things first, if you haven't yet used ChatGPT, all you need to do is go to chat.openai.com. Number 1, creating a schedule. Whether you want to try something new and create a daily, weekly, or monthly schedule, or you can use ChatGPT to prepare for a launch or a project timeline. In my example here, I've asked it to create a daily work schedule for a YouTube content creator where I wake up at 6:30 and want to enjoy a 45-minute lunch. All I need to do is tell it to go and do its magical thing. And in a matter of seconds, here's the answer that it's giving me. Yes, waking up at 6:30, my morning routine, begin filming. Here is my 45-minute lunch, but checking my emails is at 4 p.m. But I want to move that to the morning. So all I need to do is come down here and say, now move the email checking to the morning. In this revised version, here you can see that it has moved my email checking to 8 a.m. in the morning, which is great because that's when I'd like to deal with email and then not have to deal with it ever again. Now, in our second example, we're going to be looking at a schedule which is much longer in duration. In this case, I've asked it create a launch schedule for a membership site that will be released on April 1st, 2023. Include all aspects of the project, including product development, testing, and promotion. What are the results? Well, here is the sample schedule that it has given me. Starting the product development and assigning those deadlines in January, beginning the building of the membership site and testing in February, finalizing and promoting in March, ready for launch on April 1st. And what I really appreciate about this brief sample schedule, it's even included some tasks that I didn't think about after the April 1st launch. But what if this isn't quite detailed enough for me? Well, I'm going to come down here and say, now break it down into week intervals. I want to look at this at a somewhat more granular level. Maybe I'm happy with the schedule which it produced, but now I want to break it down week by week. And as you can see, it's going to break everything down by the year and the date that we're in, the time frame that I'm looking at. So this can be a fantastic way to break down a much larger project, something that can seem very daunting or intimidating, and get some great examples as to how you can approach this particular task. Tip number 2, let's see how ChatGPT can make us look a lot smarter and a lot more efficient when it comes to writing messages, in particular when it comes to writing emails. Here I've asked it to write an email that encourages the potential client to reply to my message and book a pet grooming appointment for their dog. Let's see what it comes up with. Now, what I love about this answer is not only has it given me a subject line and a professionally formatted email, but even with giving it such little details as a pet grooming business, look at all the language, look at all the descriptive words it's used, including the different breeds and sizes, well-groomed and healthy pet, basic grooming, spa grooming. We know how important it is for your pet and their environment. It has taken limited knowledge and produced something fantastic, which I can now massage, make some edits, and fill in the blanks, and then be ready to go. Think of how easy it will be to create an email sequence, either for your email newsletter or, next up, for emails where you maybe don't deal with those types of questions or those types of answers on a regular basis. In this case, I've told it to reply to this email from a frustrated client and encourage them to continue with our services. Now, in this case, I've just given an example, but you can cut and paste any email that you receive and put it after these instructions. Let's see what it comes up with. So here we have a complete email, which starts with a simple apology and then asking to understand a little bit more about what they have experienced. And by the time we get to the end of the email, we are gently inviting them to try us one more time so we can regain their trust. Now, one of the great things about using ChatGPT is that we can make additional modifications. So if I don't typically respond to an email in this level of detail, I can come down here and say, now, write it in less than 50 words. So this time around, it's taken that entire email and condensed it into just 3 sentences. This might be a lot more appropriate if I'm responding to someone via Google ratings or maybe on a social media platform. All of the key points are still there, but in a much more condensed format. So whether you need to expand, reduce, or change the tone, you can do so in just a few simple instructions. Now, a third way to get the most out of ChatGPT and to save a lot of time is to summarize a lengthy article or meeting notes. How often have you been sent a long document and you need to preview it or summarize it in just a few moments? For example, here I've landed on an article which seems to be a complete guide to setting up a membership website. And I can tell by the scroll bar on the right-hand side that this is indeed a very, very lengthy article. But what if I just want to get the gist of this article or just share some of the key points with a potential client? Well, all I need to do is give it some instructions, such as summarize this article in less than 200 words and then paste in the link of that article. Now, in just a few seconds, it's going to scan and only pull out the key points or the key ideas from this particular article. In this example, it's taken thousands of words and broken it down into 4 key paragraphs. But what if I want something even a little more digestible? Well, let's give it some additional instructions. I'm going to tell it to now break it down into 4 actionable steps. And in just a few seconds, I have the 4 key points listed in order, something that I can now share maybe in a presentation or deliver as a part of a training. This makes it so much more easy to digest and to retain that information. Of course, you may always want to go back to the original article to find the details and find out other pieces of information, but this can be a fantastic way to summarize meeting notes, articles, or anything else that you come across. And don't forget, if you're enjoying this video so far and are wanting to learn more ways to save time, be sure to subscribe right here to the Simpletivity channel. Next up, let's take a look at how ChatGPT can actually solve many of our technical challenges, including helping us with our software. For example, many people ask me questions about Gmail and other Google products. And although I try to read every single comment right here on the Simpletivity channel, I simply can't respond to every single question. Well, let's see if ChatGPT can do a good job in my absence. So in this example, I've asked it to create a filter in Gmail that will automatically move messages from my inbox that are more than 30 days old to a new label called Moved After 30. And in just a few moments, it's given us a very easy 12-step process to follow. Everything from where we need to click to find our filters, what exactly we need to enter into that search bar, and how to skip the inbox and apply the new label. What about something else, maybe like a spreadsheet or an Excel formula? I don't know about you, but I often forget certain formulas or how to structure them within a spreadsheet. In this case, I've asked it to create a combined sum of 2 columns in Excel, where the first column is weighted 1.7 times more than the second column. All I need to do is hit enter on my keyboard, and it's going to come up with that answer in just a few seconds. Often, it will start with an opening paragraph, just briefly describing what it's going to do. But what I especially like with its answer is that it's going to explain what is happening and how this function is working. Now I've got this Excel formula that I can simply copy and paste and use to my liking within my Excel spreadsheet or Google Sheet. Speaking of complex, no one likes to feel stupid. So what if you struggle to understand a complicated topic? Well, here within ChatGPT, we can use things such as explain to me like I'm 5, or 10, or 20, or whatever age you think is appropriate, and then give it something that you don't fully understand. In this case, I'm asking it a question about cryptocurrency. Now, I think it's done a very good job of explaining this to a small child, but maybe I want to present this and add a little more detail, but also a little more fun. So what I've done is I've said, explain it to me like I'm 10, but use terms and analogies in the style of a Western movie. Let's see what it comes up with. And just like that, I've got this same basic description, but I've got everything else that I wanted. Just like in the Wild West, people used to mine for gold. Now people use computers to mine for Bitcoin. So whatever you are looking for, this can be especially helpful if you are sharing information or wanting to make something a little more creative for your audience or your team. Next up, let's take a look at how we can create agreements or contracts based on our needs. Now, of course, there's a caveat here. You should always rely on professional legal help before issuing or using agreements and contracts. But this can be a great place to start to flesh out the details of your agreement. In this example, I've said create a simple coaching agreement where the client will receive 4 coaching sessions for $995. Now, what's so great about the results is that not only does it include all of the details, including some additional ones, such as my cancellation policy, but it has formatted it in the right way. It's got everything listed here, including the client's name and what they will be referred to hereafter. But even if we scroll down to the bottom, it's even included a client's signature and date. So this can be a great starting place, especially if you're worried about forgetting something as you're putting your agreements or contracts together. Now, I've got one more great way to get the most out of ChatGPT, but just before I share that tip, I'd love to hear from you. What are some of your favorite ChatGPT prompts? Be sure to let me know and share it with others in the comments down below. Now, so far, we've talked mostly about getting ChatGPT to generate new content for us. But perhaps one of the most powerful ways to use this tool is to enhance our own, make it better, or maybe make it geared towards a particular audience. Think about all of your marketing material. Think about your biography. Think about your website, your email, anything else that you use on a day-to-day basis. How can you refine it or gear it towards a particular audience? In this case, I've said, make the following more exciting and geared towards busy professionals. And all I've done is cut and paste some content from my own website. And in just seconds, I certainly have a much more exciting description here, including a Slay the Dragon reference in the opening sentence. Of course, I may want to revise and change this, but think of the possibilities that this opens up. And don't forget, you can continue to refine your prompt so you can get closer to what you're looking for. I'm going to take this same piece of text, but now I'm going to tell it, make the reader fear that they will miss out if they don't contact me today. Of course, this can be a very powerful marketing tool. It may not be relevant for everything that you're doing or every product or service, but see how it can change things and make it closer to what you're wanting. And if you're wanting to save even more time as a part of your day, be sure to watch this video next, where I show you a free Chrome extension, which just might change the way you work.